Hello students, today we are going to talk about life processes, and this video is specially for the children of class 10th. Under life processes we have a very important topic to discuss, which is called nutrition. Now, as we know, what is nutrition? Nutrition is providing nutrients to the body. बॉडी में जब आप न्यूट्रिएंट्स यानी कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, मिनरल्स, विटामिन्स, इसेंशियल ऑयल्स, वाटर एट्सेट्रा, जब आप सब ये चीज़ें मिला के आप अपने फूड में कंज्यूम करते हो, तो उसको आप न्यूट्रिशन कहलाते हैं. न्यूट्रिशन इज बेसिकली द बेसिस ऑफ लिविंग. अगर आप खाना नहीं खाते हैं तो आप न्यूट्रिशन लेस हैं. नाउ अंडर न्यूट्रिशन द फर्स्ट टॉपिक विच इज कमिंग अप इज ऑटोट्रॉफ्स. नाउ व्हाट आर ऑटोट्रॉफ्स? दीज आर द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच मेक देयर ओन फूड. मीन्स द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच कैन मेक देयर ओन फूड such as plants, they are called autotrophs. Auto means self. Means when they can prepare their own food and they can consume it by themselves, it is called autotrophs. Now, under autotrophs, the main important topic which comes, that how does the plant prepare their food? Plants prepare their food by the process called photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? Green plants, I have to mention it green. Why? Because only green plants undergo the process of photosynthesis. If I say mushroom, mushroom is non-green. Mushroom is a saprophyte. It is not a autotroph. So only green plants. Green plants prepare their own food with the help of carbon dioxide, water and chlorophyll. In presence of sunlight. Now this sunlight factor is very important. If you mention only carbon dioxide, water and chlorophyll, and if sunlight is missing, your definition is wrong. So you have to mention this full definition for getting full marks. And the food which is prepared is in form of starch. So this is the full definition of photosynthesis, and the equation of photosynthesis is, because when you go for your exams they always ask the definition plus equation of photosynthesis. Now equation goes like this: 6 CO2 plus 12 H2O in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Both the factors you are going to write like this. In presence of sunlight and chlorophyll gives you C6H12O6 plus 6O2 plus 6H2O. And this H2O is released in by the process of transpiration. So I hope you must have understood the equation. Once again we are repeating it. 6 CO2, yani 6 molecules of CO2 plus 12 molecules of H2O. They both are going to combine in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll to give you 1 molecule of glucose. This is glucose. What is the formula of glucose? C6H12O6, and 6 molecules of oxygen and 6 molecules of water are given out. So this is overall equation of photosynthesis. Now, very often a question is asked, when I have mentioned chlorophyll here, children get confused what is chlorophyll and what is the difference between chlorophyll and chloroplast. So what is chlorophyll? It is a green colored pigment present in leaves where chloroplast is found. Now, children, if you go back to your class 7 or your class 8 times, you must have heard about the plant cell. Now, when we know that, see, this is a cell wall. And in plant cell, you have always noticed there is an organelle called chloroplast. This organelle, chloroplast, is not present in animal cell. Chloroplast is the organelle which is only present in plant cell and it contains green color pigment called chlorophyll. These all the organelles of chloroplast, they are only present in green colored plants. Okay? So, now if I show you a transverse section of leaf, we need to go for this section. We need to learn about this because this is a very frequently asked question. TS means transverse section of leaves. Now, if we see a transverse section of leaf, you see the upper epidermis, you see the lower epidermis. In the lower epidermis, you see many stomatas are present. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Stomatas are the openings through which the air and exchange of air takes place and loss of water takes place. And this is the minute things which you see here is chloroplast. Now, the upper layer after epidermis is mesophyll cell. Mesophyll cell and then bundle sheath, and then inside the bundle sheath, if you see, bundle sheath means what? The package of xylem and phloem. See clearly. This is the outermost part which is known as phloem, and these are the xylem particles. So these are the xylem and phloem. What is the function of phloem? Phloem conducts food and xylem conducts water. So xylem conducts water and phloem conducts food. Mesophyll cells are the other cells other than epidermis. And inside the mesophyll cells and all, there are many chloroplasts which are present. And these chloroplasts contain green color pigment which is known as chlorophyll. So I hope this diagram must be clear to you all. Moving ahead, structure of chloroplast. Now, we have seen the dots behind. These dots are called chloroplast. And now, how does a chloroplast look like? That we are going to discuss. So, the next topic is structure of chloroplast. Now, this is the structure of chloroplast. In this, you can see oval-shaped structure. You get points when you draw the diagram oval shape. Outer membrane, inner membrane, then there is a pile of thylakoid. Thylakoids jo hain wo arrange rehte hain pile ki form mein. Aur is pure pile ko aap bolte hain grana. So grana is the piles of thylakoid. Thylakoid, as I've shown you, one single thylakoid on the upper surface. These thylakoid, they contain the particles of chlorophyll which will absorb sunlight. Each thylakoid pile, which is called grana, is connected with fret, F-R-E-T, fret. And this all lies inside the matrix called stroma. So this is a very simple structure of chloroplast and you get full marks for drawing this structure. Now, Thylakoids contain green color chlorophyll, which helps to trap the sunlight. This is a very important line. Chlorophyll helps to trap sunlight and with the help of quantosomes. Quantosomes are the energy packets, small packets to absorb minute light particles. So quantosomes, these are small packets that will absorb minute light particles, and those minute light particles are called photons. Photons ko absorb karne ke liye quantosomes hote hain, and these quantosomes, where are they present? They are present in upper layer of thylakoid. Now, this was the structure of chloroplast. Now, steps in photosynthesis. Now, how does the photosynthesis takes place? It generally takes place in two ways. Two steps are needed to complete photosynthesis. Now, first step is called light reaction. Light reaction is also called Hill reaction because it was discovered by the scientist called Robert Hill. So, light reaction, Hill reaction, and this is also called photochemical phase. Why this is called photochemical phase? This is called photochemical phase because this light reaction will only be carried with the help of sunlight. So it doesn't mean that dark reaction will carry during the night time. No. Light reaction and dark reaction, they are carried along side by side, but only that dark reaction do not depend on sunlight. So, light reaction needs sunlight 100% while dark reaction does not need sunlight. Now, light reaction takes place in the thylakoid because chlorophyll is present there. And dark reaction, it takes place inside the stroma. So, stroma is a jelly-like substance which will not allow the light to penetrate. So the reaction here becomes dark. While thylakoid, they are the only places where sunlight reach properly and chlorophyll will help the sunlight to be trapped. So this is the site of light reaction and this is the site of dark reaction. So when we say light reaction, the first step which comes is activation of chlorophyll molecule. Now, how does the chlorophyll molecule gets activated? Activation means when light reaction will start, the sunlight will fall on the leaf and the chlorophyll molecule inside the chloroplast will start activating. एक्टिवेशन का मतलब होता है जब किसी चीज को एनर्जी मिल जाती है तो वो अपने एक्साइटेड स्टेट में आ जाता है. एक्टिवेटेड मींस एक्साइटेड, एंड व्हेन इट इज एक्साइटेड देन वी नो इट इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट इन अ हाई एनर्जी लेवल. सो ड्यूरिंग दिस एक्साइटेशन लॉट ऑफ एनर्जी और इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर रिलीज्ड. Now, after activation of chlorophyll molecule, photolysis of water takes place. Now, water we are already providing the plant by the help of roots. The roots, they will absorb the water for the plant, and photolysis of water will take place now. The water molecule which is present inside the plant will be splitting up. The splitting of water molecule means the water molecule is going to be split up into two ions, H ions and OH ions. H ions are the positive ions while OH ions are the negative ions. These OHions will later on help out to liberate oxygen. So if we say inside the equation, if we say 6CO2 and 12H2O, and we say that oxygen which is given by the plant comes from water, is correct. The oxygen which is given by the plants is never been liberated by CO2, because CO2 is not splitting. Water is the molecule which is splitting. So when we say from where do we get oxygen, so you will always say that water gets splitted up into H and OH ions, and these OH ions will later on help out to liberate oxygen, whereas H ions will reduce energy packet NADP. Now, what is NADP? It is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. ये एक एनर्जी पैकेट है, या फिर आप एसिमिलेटरी पावर बोल सकते हो इसको. इसको रिड्यूस करने के लिए आपको एच आयंस की जरूरत पड़ेगी. तो फोटोलिसिस ऑफ वाटर में यू आर गोइंग टू से स्प्लिटिंग ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल इनटू एच एंड ओएच आयंस, वेयर ओएच आयंस विल गिव राइज टू ऑक्सीजन मॉलिक्यूल्स लिबरेटिंग द ऑक्सीजन मॉलिक्यूल, एंड एच आयंस विल कंबाइंड विद एनएडीपी. This is the second step of light reaction. Now the third step. Now first let me see what is, let me tell you what is NADP. NADP, as I already told you, is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. Dinucleotide phosphate. Which will get reduced into NADPH, because H ion from there has combined into it, and it will be used later on in dark reaction, because it will be the assimilatory power. Assimilatory means the power which is going to, which we are going to use in dark reaction. Now after the second step, we have third step now, photophosphorylation. Photo means light, phospho means the phosphate molecule, rylation means addition. So addition of one phosphate to ADP. ADP is adenine dinucleotide phosphate. इसमें आप जब एक मॉलिक्यूल ऑर्गेनिक इनऑर्गेनिक फॉस्फेट का ऐड करोगे तो वो एडीपी में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा. एडीपी इज लोअर फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी, एंड टू कंप्लीट द अपर फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी विच इज कॉल्ड एटीपी, द फुल फॉर्म इज एडिनोसिन ट्राइफॉस्फेट. एडीपी में जब आप वन इनऑर्गेनिक फॉस्फेट ऐड करते हैं इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सनलाइट टू गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू एटीपी, इट इज नोन एज फोटोफॉस्फोराइलेशन. विदाउट सनलाइट इट विल नॉट बी पॉसिबल. सो फोटोफॉस्फोराइलेशन इज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ एडिशन ऑफ वन फॉस्फेट मॉलिक्यूल टू एडीपी इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सनलाइट. एंड व्हाई इट इज डन, व्हाट विल एटीपी इज बीइंग यूज्ड लेटर ऑन, it is again the assimilatory power. So this assimilatory power will be used later on in dark reaction. So let us just see the end products of light reaction. Oxygen, which is released during photolysis of water, NADPH combining more H to it will make it NADPH2, and ATP. These two things will be used as power in dark reaction, where carbon dioxide is converted into glucose. CO2 is going to get converted into glucose with the help of ribulose diphosphate. If you need to know, if you need to mention the name, it's okay. Otherwise, you will just say that carbon dioxide within the series of steps, it will get converted into glucose.